I'm Beth with 50 Plus Beauty, and I'm excited that you're here with me today to see my 2017 beauty tool faves. These are my absolute favorite beauty tools I have used throughout the last year, and I'm so excited to share them with you. But first, I hope you'll subscribe and click the little bell to be notified of my future videos. That way we can all get more grown up together and have a wonderful second half. My first favorite beauty tool is this little Tweezerman metal lash comb. And you know, I use this every single morning and have all 365 days of the past year because I pretty much wear makeup every day. And how you use it is just before you curl your lashes, you go ahead and give them a quick comb. And then once you curl your lashes and put mascara on, between each coat, I go ahead and use this little metal lash comb. It gets out the clumps and it smooths your lashes out and it gets them kind of in place where they need to be. It's absolutely fabulous. In fact, I really could not do mascara without this. Now, my second essential tool is this Real Techniques sculpting brush. And how you use that is you go underneath your cheekbones and put your contour on. And as many of you know, I was contour challenged and I just realized that my face is looking very flat because I had not applied any contour. Let's go ahead and do that. I don't have my mirror right in front of me. Let's see if I can do this just using my monitor. And I had used several different brushes through the course of the year. In fact, one of them I ordered from the internet and paid $50 for and used once. It is nowhere near as good as this little brush. It has very nice tight bristles. There we go. And it just absolutely allows you to get that contour exactly where you want it. Let's do a little along the bottom cheek line here, or chin line, I guess that is. And then bring it down here on your neck, just to give you a little bit of a shadow that looks like you have a very well-sculpted chin. That was that little brush in action, and it is fabulous. Now, the next essential tool I have is this IT Cosmetics Luxe Wand Ball, I think it's called. It's an absolutely fabulous little powder brush. I use this brush every single morning when I do my makeup, and it is wonderful to take that loose powder and just put it all over your face. I have never found a powder brush that I like nearly as well as this. It's a little on the pricey side, but for me, when I use it every day, it's absolutely worth it. And what I've noticed is that it really presses that powder exactly where it needs to be. It allows the powder to go on thinly, but also it really gets it into all those little fine pores. And I really have a problem with pores, and this brush helps it look like I'm poreless. Now, my next essential beauty tool is this Instapop Brush Duo. This is an absolutely fabulous little brush set. I've been using them pretty much every single day and I'm finding them to be indispensable. And really, the more familiar I become with these Real Techniques brushes, I think they're some of the best on the market, even better than my Sigma brushes, my Morphe brushes, my more high-cost brushes. This little set is only about $10 and it is fabulous. Here's how it works. This is a little angled shader brush, which is absolutely perfect. In fact, I used it for my eye makeup this morning. It's absolutely perfect to brush on that lid shadow. And then this little brush is a little angled brush, which is absolutely perfect for the crease. It just gets in there absolutely beautifully, totally precision application there. And again, this solves the need of getting into the fine areas like your crease and really putting that eyeshadow exactly where you want it. These little brushes are absolutely fabulous and they become really indispensable to me. Now, my next essential beauty tool is this Sephora shader in size 18. It's just a little tiny brush there. And how I use this brush is I use it under the eyelashes to get that little smoky look down there. And also, it's a fabulous little brush to get that outer V. It's absolutely perfect. Many of the eyeshadow brushes out there are just too large, and this is a little fine detail brush. I've never found one better. Love this brush. Hey, this next beauty tool was a total surprise to me. It was something that I had seen other YouTubers talk about, and I thought it was kind of ridiculous. And what this is, it's my Clarisonic Mia, and you can do it with the Clarisonic as well. But it comes with a little brush head, and I think it's about $35, and I'll put the link below. But it has a makeup applying brush head here, and you can use this to apply foundation, they say contour, and all kinds of things, which I've really never found it to be useful for that. But it is surprisingly good at applying foundation. As many of you know, for the past year, I was really using this Artiste brush or the Artiste dupe brushes to put on foundation. And quite honestly, they feel just fabulous. And that was probably one of the main reasons I thought they worked so well. One thing I noticed about using this Artiste brush is that every day around 1 or 2 o'clock when I go in the bathroom at work, I'd look at my face and large chunks of my foundation would just be missing and you could see large pores. And for some reason, my foundation just wasn't staying on. Well, then I started experimenting, and I'm going to be doing a video about this later. And so if you're not a subscriber, go ahead and subscribe and click that little bell. It's what I learned that totally makes my foundation stay on all day and makes it look absolutely flawless. What you do is you dab your foundation all over your face, and I spray this with a little bit of setting spray. I use the Urban Decay All Nighter, which I really think is a fantastic setting spray. But then I just kind of put the foundation all over, just kind of use little circular motions all over. And this surprised the heck out of me. I thought this was just a gimmick. Who would ever think that a Clarisonic brush head would actually give you a wonderful foundation result? But it does. One thing I did notice though, is you'll get a few little lines, a few little streaks. And so what I do is, again, I spray this little sponge with some setting spray, and then I go in and just pat in the areas just all around the face. And I've noticed that that helps this foundation wear even longer. But again, I can't recommend this Clarisonic brush head highly enough. Now, my next beauty fave of this year is this Hydro Nano Mist Spray. And this is an absolutely wonderful little mister. And how I found out about this is from Carol of the O. Carol Show. And if you have not been there, she is fabulous. I could not believe it. I thought she was like in her 40s, and apparently she is near 70, and she is young and sexy and vibrant. She's this absolutely gorgeous brunette who is smart and funny, and you should see her beautiful background that she does her videos in. She is wonderful, and I've put her link below, but I saw her talk about this not too long ago on her channel, and again, I'll have a link to that specific video. I was having a problem with setting sprays because many of them, you could mist them on your face, but sometimes it would look like you had big chunks of water all over your face. It would make like water spots, and that's not a good look at all. And how this works is you just load this with your little setting spray, and this is under $20. It's a fabulous buy. And then you just press this here, and it turns to red, and then you get this little fine mist all over your face. And as you can see that, I hope you can see that. It's absolutely fabulous, and so you get no little splotches, no little drop marks over your face. You just get an even application of a beautiful setting spray. This is absolutely a fabulous product, and I can't thank Carol enough for it. It is really changing my game in terms of using those setting sprays. And for those of you who aren't familiar with using setting sprays and you don't know the benefits, they are really fabulous in terms of keeping your makeup on and also removing that powdery, cakey look that we all get when we apply too much powder, especially as we get a little more grown up. Oh, Carol, thank you. Now, the next product is probably very obvious to many of you, and don't look too close because this is my very well-used Reach Flosser. But instead of getting the little floss out and wrapping it all around and doing the floss bit, I know they say you should do it that way because that way, you know, your teeth get more wrapped with a floss, which I know is a good thing. And I do that every now and then. But on a daily basis, it's so much easier to just use this little flossing tool. And you just put the little head on there and you just go in and floss your teeth. I can't believe I'm flossing my teeth on YouTube. But anyway, it is absolutely wonderful. I asked my dentist about it, and she said, well, if it keeps you flossing twice a day, it's worth it. Now, the next beauty product that I highly recommend is this Quip electric toothbrush. This is absolutely wonderful for brushing your teeth on the go. And Octoly sent me this, but I have to admit, when it came in, my husband was like, oh my gosh, you ordered a Quip? I want one. And he had been wanting to order one, so I said, you know, go ahead and order one. And it comes in like four different colors, I think. And I got mine in the gold, which I really like. You just keep this in your purse. And then after lunch, you just turn it on right here, and then you just brush each tooth, and it's absolutely wonderful. And it runs on one little AAA battery, so you never have to worry about keeping it on a charger or something like that. And if you don't want to take this portably, if you just want to keep this on your mirror at home, it sticks on your mirror like this, and so it just stays right there in a very handy way. I use a different electric toothbrush at home, but for me, this answers a huge need because it dawned on me maybe a couple of months ago that I really try to take good care of my teeth, but that every day at lunch, I was, you know, eating lunch and then not brushing my teeth, or occasionally I would have a candy bar and I would not brush my teeth. And I thought, how unhealthy is that? And at that point, I wanted to find something that I could keep in my purse, a little portable toothbrush system, and that's exactly what this is. It's very reasonable in price, and I feel it cleans my teeth much better than just a standard non-electric toothbrush. This is absolutely fabulous. And if you want your mouth to be healthy and your teeth to look their best, I think this is a wonderful beauty tool. Now, my last product is the Skinny Mint 28-Day Teatox Program. And I was sent this by the Octoly people. And unfortunately, you know, I just went through having my Mohs surgery, and so things got a little discombobulated. And so it took me a long time to get around to reviewing this. And they emailed me and they said, are you using it? Can you post a review? And I'm like, well, I've only used it about 2 weeks. And they said that would be long enough to tell you how it works. So I'm going to go ahead and do my review. But unfortunately, it really didn't do much for me in the 2 weeks. Maybe if I'd been able to wait the 28 days, it would have. It tasted good. The idea behind this is it's kind of a detox tea. You do one tea bag of tea in the morning, and it does taste good. It tastes like mint. And then you do one tea bag every other evening, and it is supposed to not only detox your body, but it's also supposed to help you lose a little bit of weight. And I've seen other YouTubers where they have had that result, but I did weigh myself before and after the about 2 weeks that I used it, and I really didn't notice any difference. So I'm sorry, this is not one of my faves. I wish I'd had a little more time to review it. Now I'm going to have several more 2017 fave videos coming. I have an eyeshadow palette favorites coming. I have a contour and highlighter fave. So if you're not a subscriber, I hope you subscribe and click that little bell. That's a good way to get notified of my future videos and join the 50 plus beauty nation of women determined to make their second half their best half. And I always like to leave you with a little thought for the day. And I've been doing that lately with the I Can Do It cards. This is a Louise Hay card deck. Let's go ahead and choose a card here. This is a good one. My happy thoughts help create my healthy body. My happy thoughts help create my healthy body. And then it says, filling my mind with pleasant thoughts is the quickest road to health. And ladies, this is so, so true. Somewhere along the way, I read that negative thoughts and kind of grumpy, grouchy thoughts actually acidify our body, which is not what we want. We don't want those acid thoughts, those mean, nasty, angry thoughts, those judgmental thoughts eating away at our body. You know, I kind of experienced the link between health and attitude about 15, 20 years ago. My sister and I had worked for my parents' company, and through a long series of weird situations, we ended up getting fired. I basically sold National Walmart, and they became very, very wealthy, and then I ended up fired. And you know, there's a lot to that. There's two sides to the story, but to make a long story short, for the next like 10 or 15 years, even though I continued to do family things with them, I really resented the heck out of them. And it just ate away at my body. I could almost feel it, those angry thoughts and that lack of forgiveness. And during that period, I developed rheumatoid arthritis. And I really think looking back that it was all that hatred that I had inside of me that was just eating away at my bones. It was acidifying my body and it was causing me pain. And I think it is so true that our happy thoughts help create our healthy bodies. So in the second half, ladies, let's try to remember to guard our thoughts. And when we start to have a negative, mean-spirited thought, to just stop that and switch it to a more pleasant thought, to think about our blessings and to think about what we're grateful for. Because when we switch those negative, harsh thoughts to more pleasant thoughts, not only are we happier, we're probably healthier too. Take care. See you next time.